we talk about the colic in horses. Colic in horses is defined as abdominal pain, but it's important to note that it's a clinical symptom rather than a diagnosis, right? Now, different causes can manifest with similar signs of distress in the horse, and action can spell the difference between a brief moment of discomfort and a life-threatening problem. The most common forms of colic are gastrointestinal in nature and are most often related to the gastrointestinal tract. Among domesticated animals, horse is the one which is most suffering from the colic. The etiology includes impaction of the stomach or intestine, mural or extramural blockage of stomach or intestine, dilatation of stomach or intestine, intestinal spasm, paralytic ileus, gastric reflux, peritonitis and other inflammatory conditions of the stomach or intestine, verminous arteritis of mesenteric vessels, intussusception, torsion or strangulation of the intestine. Common clinical signs include the abdominal pain, discomfort, flank watching, flank biting, pawing and frequent lying down. These are the signs. Kicking at the abdomen, protrusion of the penis, sham drinking of the water, sawhorse stance, frequent attempts to urinate and defecate, ping sound in combined auscultation and percussion is felt. The incidence of colic in the general horse population has been between 4% and 10% over the course of the average lifespan. The types of colic and their diagnosis. The first is the gas colic. This is often caused by buildup of gas in the horse's digestive tract. Horse's diagnosis may involve physical examination, listening for gut sounds and rectal palpation. Impaction colic. This occurs when a blockage, often of feed or other indigestible material, obstructs the intestines, right? The diagnosis involves physical examination, monitoring for decreased manure production, and sometimes rectal palpation to feel for impacted material, right? Spasmodic colic. Spasm in the horse's intestinal muscles can cause this type of colic. Diagnosis may involve observing the horse's behavior and response to pain relief medication, right? Then there is the twisted intestine or torsion colic. This is a severe and life-threatening condition where the intestine twists on itself, causing blood flow obstruction, right? Diagnosis often requires advanced imaging techniques like ultrasound or x-rays. And then there is enteritis or colitis, which is the inflammation of the intestine, can lead to colic. Medical management tips for colic in the horse. Assess the severity. Determine the severity of colic considering clinical signs and financial resources. Surgery may be necessary for severe cases, right? Analgesia and sedation, administer analgesics like NSAIDs, flunixin, meglumin, xylazine or atropine sulfate for mild pain, and combining opioids with alpha 2 agonist can extend the pain relief. Then nasogastric intubation may be required to remove the gastric reflux, administer fluids and monitor colic progression. This is crucial for cases involving strangulation, obstruction or enteritis, right? Then fluid support, administer fluids orally via nasogastric tube or intravenous catheter to restore hydration and electrolyte balance. Adjust fluid rates based on clinical examination findings. Then intestinal lubricants use like mineral oil for large colon impactions can be given to the horse. Detergents like dioctyl sodium sulfosuccinate can help soften impactions and stimulate intestinal motility, so they can be given to the horse. Then nutritional support. Withhold feed during colic episodes. Don't allow the horse to feed anything. Consider parenteral nutrition in prolonged cases and gradually reintroduce feed with clinical when clinical signs improve. Then endotoxemia prevention. Be vigilant about endotoxemia, a serious colic complication, and one must be very careful, otherwise the horse may die very fast. Administer fluids with colloids or hypertonic saline and consider drugs that bind endotoxins such as polymyxin B and biosponge. These can be used. Then laminitis prevention. Watch for laminitis in horses with endotoxemia. right? Prophylactic measures may include NSAIDs, DMSO, icing of the feet, frog support, and heparin to reduce blood clot formation, right? Case-specific drug treatments use specific drugs for identified causes of colic, such as spasmolytic agent, buscopan, promotility agent, metoclopramide, lidocaine, and anti-inflammatories, antimicrobials, phenylephrine. Right? Surgery may be necessary in 1 to 2% of